Hi, it's Kiffin LeBates here, and today I'm going to talk about the Ethereum ERC-2981 standard, also known as the NFT royalty standard. And if your smart contract is compliant with this standard, then it will contain a function called royalty info, which takes two arguments, a token ID and an amount, and it returns a receiver address and a payment amount. It's that simple. To put it in plain English, if your NFT contract is compliant with the NFT royalty standard, you ask it, given that I've paid this much for this token, what's the royalty? And the answer that comes back is the royalty is this much and you need to pay it to this address. So it really is that simple. I mean, it's literally just a piece of information generating functionality. It does a calculation for you. You know, if you say, I have bought token 3 for 100 ETH, and the contract knows that the royalty is 5%, it will come back saying you need to pay 5 ETH to this address because that's where the royalties are supposed to go. And the reason why it's that simple is because you just can't enforce royalties in smart contracts at this moment in time. I've had a few ideas about this, but they've not really gone anywhere substantive. And so the best you can do is just give advice. And that is reflected in the standard, even though when you go and look at the document, there are reams and reams of text describing what the standard is all about, what motivated it, and what problems there are. It boils down to that one simple thing. It's a calculator. It works out a percentage for you and tells you where that percentage is supposed to go. So that is the ERC-2981 NFT royalty standard for Ethereum. There really isn't much more to say about it than that. Hope you found it interesting, and I'll see you in the next video soon. Bye for now.